That is a welcome sound, yeah. Right? I mean, it woke up the people in my house overnight, but we were happy to see that. The rain falling this morning, it has arrived. Of course, we also, as we just mentioned, we've seen the lightning, we've heard the thunder all across the area. These videos we got in just over the last hour or so shows a little bit of what people saw overnight throughout the region. That rain, we know, will help clear out the smoke that we've all been living under for the past week and a half. So let us know what it looks like right now in your neighborhood. You can actually text us pictures or text us a video. Just use that number you see right there on the screen, 503-226-5088. It is Friday, Brenda and Rod, we do have the rain. I'm thinking a lot of people may be up right now because the thunder woke them up, but right. As long as you're with us, grab that cup of coffee, and Rod's gonna get us all caught up now on what exactly is happening outside.
Yeah, let's start with Doppler radar behind me. So the biggest cluster that we're likely going to see all day has now moved up into Clark County, still producing lightning, but it is weakening overall in terms of the rain rates. If you move south, everything is moving south to north. So you can see a red dot just off of Mount Jefferson. That's heavy rains in that fire zone of Marion County, now moving over the fire zone toward the Riverside Fire up in Clackamas County. That's great news. And then we have more heavy rain that could turn into thunderstorms just outside of Newport. Again, everything is going to be moving south to north across your area. These have been big storms, but thankfully the biggest headline is how much rain they have been dropping. Multiple reports of more than an inch of rain coming down in less than 30 minutes. As you look at downtown Portland getting some rain moving up into the city, and then you see what's left of that big cluster of storms with the lightning moving up down to around or up around Mount St. Helens. So these storms so far have had a history of basically the stronger ones moving north at a clip of 30 miles per hour. There's a potential of half inch hail. We've had multiple reports of gusty winds with these stronger storms to about 45 miles per hour. And again, a lot of them have been dumping over an inch of rain. In fact, we've had reports nearing 2 inches of rain in roughly a half of an hour. So just big time welcome relief in that department. 64 is our temperature. I mentioned earlier, as you look at the day planner, the continuation of heavy showers, maybe some more thunder and lightning. I really think it's this early morning blast that we're getting, so to speak, that will end up being the strongest storms of the day. Good news there, and a quick reminder, if you're going to be hitting the roads early this morning, expect that you're going to find some ponding, some big puddles on the area roadways, so drive with caution as these rainstorms have really been dumping, guys.
Yeah, but some impressive numbers. Thank you, Rod. Also, some of our viewers have been calling into KGW telling us that the power has gone out in their home. That's the downside. Pacific Power has a note on its website saying there are scattered outages because of the thunderstorms. Right now, there are 125 outages in the state affecting almost 6,000 people. But we should note, a lot of these power outages have been going on since the fires began.